Welcome students. Now I am going to discuss about in second term science subject. The first lesson, food, is a continuous part of method of cooking. In last class we have learnt about food and types of food. Food is the basic needs of our life. The food is the main source, natural source, and then that means plants and animal source. The food, they have two types, raw food and cooked food. In last class already studied about these topics. Now let us see about the method of cooking. The first method, moist heat. The moist heat, they have three types: boiling, steaming, and pressure cooker. Already I explained about these topics. The next method of cooking is dry heat. The dry heat, they have three types. The first one, roasting, frying, and baking. And the third method of cooking is other methods. The other methods, they have two types. The first one, microwave cooking, and the solar cooking. The method of cooking, they have three types. The first one, moist heat method. Already I explained about these topics: boiling, steaming, and the pressure cooker. Then second topic, dry heat. The dry heat, they have three types: roasting, frying, baking. Then third method of cooking is other methods: microwave cooking and solar cooking. Now let us see about dry heat method. Now let us see about next two methods of cooking. Dry heat method, it has three types: roasting, baking, frying. Roasting, it is a method of cooking food by heating on a tawa or frying pan without covering it. For example, groundnuts, cashew nuts, fish, meat, etc. Next one, frying. It is a method of cooking food in a hot oil. For example, chips, puri, etc. The dry heat methods mean cooking without any water or steam, although some kinds of cooking oil is then used. Dry heat methods are for foods which are naturally tender. Next methods, microwave cooking and solar cooking. This is the example of microwave cooking. It avoids cooking large food items. It arranges items evenly on a plate to achieve even heating. Cover food with a plastic wrap or a lid. Loosen or the lid to prevent a built up of steam. Next one, solar cooking. Solar cooker is advice which uses the energy of direct sunlight to heat, cook and other food materials. This is the example of solar cooking.
Next, cooking habits. Some good cooking habits are given. The first one, wash your hands with the soap before cooking. Second one, wash vegetables and fruits before cutting. Third one, wash cooking vessels and knives. Fourth one, don't cook food for a long time because it destroys the nutrients present in the food. Then fifth point, don't use the same oil for cooking food many times. Then sixth point, using the food items after their expiry date is not good for health. Next, cooking utensils. Utensils are in different shapes and sizes. We use specific utensils for each cooking method. Clay pots were used earlier. Stainless steel and aluminium vessels are now generally used for cooking. These are the examples of cooking utensils. For example, stainless steel and aluminium vessels. Next, cooking in clay pot. Clay pots are well suited for all types of cooking. Cooking in clay pots improved the quality and taste of food and also retains the nutrients. The natural insulation properties of clay cause heat and moisture to balance and circulate throughout the pot and keep the nutrients unharmed and prevent the dish from burning. These are the examples of clay pots. Some benefits of clay pot cooking are: the first one, easy to digest. Second one, preserves the nutrients. Third one, needs less oil for cooking. Fourth one, adds flavor to the dish. Fifth one, keeps the food warm for a long time. Sixth one, it keeps the food from becoming stale soon. Then last one, alkaline property in the pot neutralizes the acidic property in the food. Students, today's topic, next two methods of cooking and cooking habits, then using cooking utensils and clay pots. I hope all are understood today's topic. Thank you for listening, students.